This one is bittersweet today. Bitter that the creator of today's character is no longer with us, but sweet for the epic, clear-as-day memories from my childhood that he's left me with. I've left this for so long past his death because I very much didn't want to ride any of the buzz surrounding it, or anything like that. I'm hoping that this stays within the scope of folks who regularly watch my stuff, and fingers crossed you can relate to most of this. Akira Toriyama, as most of you watching this would, I assume, know that he's passed away. The father of the legacy that is Dragon Ball, a universe that many folks have at least heard of, even if in passing, or seen something from. For me, I can say that, like most of the Aussies my age, particularly on the East Coast, we grew up with before-school airings of Pokemon, Digimon, Beyblade, Zoids, Dragon Ball Z, and more. And although Pokemon had more of a physical hype around it, for me, Dragon Ball Z was definitely more of the talking point and overexcitement. Before we continue, I do apologize about my voice, I've currently got bronchitis. My memories from then are fairly vivid with certain scenes. I remember Goku endlessly traveling along the Great Snake Way after his death, Krillin dying at the hands of Frieza causing him to ascend to Super Saiyan for the first time, Future Trunks revealing about the androids and handing Frieza's ass to him like a pure badass. Many of these scenes were discussed and hyped amongst my schoolmates, and that's a fun period I haven't forgotten, which is owed to Akira. Much like the day my mate Matt told me about the rumored legendary Super Saiyan he'd heard about somewhere. Twice as tall as the Z Fighters, a monster of a man that could easily swat any of them with barely any effort. When Matt came over for a visit one weekend, we actually stopped at the old Video Easy as was tradition back then. And it just so happened that they had the VHS for Broly, and boy howdy, the hype train kicked into overdrive so fast with us rushing home to get into it immediately. Everything about it was perfect. Vegeta acting like a Muppet for most of the movie and getting fly-swatted the moment he actually went into combat, which was hilarious by the way. Goku and the rest giving everything they had and then some to stop the beast. It just left a lasting appreciation for the character. And for years I told my best mate Mike how cool it would be for Broly to be actually in the show, not just out of canon, and maybe a good guy. And then Akira went and did it for me. Well, not for me, but I can say that. I can't say I'm super into Dragon Ball these days, I haven't ever watched any of the Super. But I do stop and I still look at the art and characters and products very fondly, with these Bandai kits being on my radar for many years, and I'm sad to say that it's a regret of mine that I hadn't done one sooner. Admittedly, there were many times I almost bit the bullet seeing the original Broly, which I should have done, because he's pretty tricky to get now. So that's why he's finally being done before he's impossible to get. Or, you know, costs a kidney. I'm not a huge fan of Bandai's products, they're usually a bit too simple for my liking. They do have great quality, but, you know, it's an okay preference to have, don't get me wrong. It's just that I like a lot more physical building to do. But that being said, when I got this one, I actually did see Future Trunks, so stand by for that in the future. Now as for this kit, I gotta say, it's kinda cool. I didn't expect it to be as nice as it is, so that was a huge plus. But as for the cost, I don't believe it's worth the big price tag it's generally now associated with, as it's not really overly common to come by. And unless you're a collector or a big fan, it generally won't be worth your money. It also takes roughly about half an hour to build from my POV. Back to the movie. It's up there with Goku going Super Saiyan and Future Trunks punking Frieza as an all-time memorable thing for me. Though sadly, Broly was defeated by the runtime of the movie needing to be wrapped up in a rush, so it was kinda scuffed. But I like the idea of Goku defeating him with a solid hit where Broly was stabbed as a baby, like an Achilles heel, causing all of his power to rush out, thus the explosion. But yeah, that's probably about it for now. Rest in peace, Akira, and thank you so much for the memories you gave us.
Kakarot!
Broly! Broly, no! Don't waste your time on them!
Kakarot!
No, I don't think so. This Saiyan is mine!
Kakarot!
Whoa! Vegeta's attack was like nothing to him! Let's get something straight. Some friends call me Kakarot, but I'm Goku and you're not my friend!
Well, I might not have to wait for the comet to see you die. Seems Broly has other plans for you. Broly, attack!
No, wait!
Ah! and stop!
The Saiyan of legend! You, Kakarot! I choose you to be the first of my victims!
No, you don't!
One will do any good? Do you really believe you have enough power to beat me?
Broly, you surprised me. So I'd say you won the first round. But now it's time for round.
Kakarot, how much do you love your son?
Gohan, leave!
But father!
Now!
Give up.
I never really learned how to.
If you had just let me kill you all before, you wouldn't be dealing with this pain now. You're all complete and utter waste of Saiyan blood.
What do you say you give us a handicap?
Is that another word for coffin? What was that supposed to be, Goku?
I am Prince Vegeta! I just love a dramatic ending. Your persistence is annoying.
Vegeta, I need your power. Vegeta, more power right now.
I am a prince, the prince of all Saiyans. Why should I give my power to a Saiyan that ranks below me? Tell me why!
Oh!
lasted longer than I expected, but your final hour has arrived.
Vegeta, what are you waiting for? You're our last hope. Give me your power!
Fine, just take it, but Kakarot, finish him now!
What? Where is he getting all this energy?
Your hour has arrived!
Don't think this changes anything.
Get him, Goku. Take him out, Father.
No matter how much power you absorb from those idiots, it won't be enough to kill me. We'll see about that. You'll never really know for sure until I try.